ओके सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इश्यू दैट इज टोटल क्वालिटी मैनेजमेंट। बट बिफोर डिस्कसिंग द टोटल क्वालिटी मैनेजमेंट इट इज इंपॉर्टेंट दैट वी मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ क्वालिटी। हाउ वी कैन डिफाइन द क्वालिटी? देयर आर नंबर ऑफ न्यूमरस क्वेश्चन विच मे अराइज इन द माइंड वेदर कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ क्वालिटी इज यूनिवर्सल फॉर एवरीबडी। इफ some products are introduced by a manufacturing company, whether all customer will view the quality in the same sense or their perceptions may be different. What are the various quality parameters which can be observed to produce the quality product which is acceptable by the customer? When we start the discussion on quality management, during the process of discussing the business process re-engineering, we discuss this point that basically customer is the king. So whatever the concept of quality has to be discussed, that should be discussed from the perception of the customers, how they view the product as a quality product, how they view the services as a quality service. So that is the subject matter of today's discussion. So we will be taking the help of one very important presentation which I will be sharing with you. Let's share with you. So first we will be discussing the concept of quality management. What is the concept of quality, how it is perceived by the different people, even different stakeholders which are concerned with the company. So that is the subject matter. So quality management is composed of two words. One is quality and another is management. So management means managing the parameters of the quality and how to make it acceptable for the customer so that they are attached with the organization. So first we will be discussing the what is quality, how the customer view as quality, how the quality is defined. So if we discuss the dictionary meaning of the quality, this has various definitions which are available under the various concepts of dictionary. Some define it essential characteristics of a product. Some define it from the superiority point of view. Some definitions that are accepted in various organizations is dealt with that if the customer is satisfied with the product, that means a quality product. Some define it that if the product is fit for use, then it is a quality product. So similarly, firstly, we have to define the term quality. This may be defined from the various features of the product, various qualitative characteristics of the product. Similarly, we can define quality if we compare the two products with each other, that which product is superior to the another product. Similarly, we can define the product as a product which is satisfying the customer needs and which is fit for use. Similarly, the total quality management, if we consider it total quality management, what is the concept of total quality management? Total quality management here means whatever the parameters of quality, that may be essential characteristics, that may be superiority of the product is there, that may be customer satisfaction or fitness of the product for use is there. Managing such things, making it more acceptable to the customer. So a comprehensive organizational wide effort to improve the quality of the product services, which is applicable to all organization, is known as total quality management. So it's a comprehensive organization wide effort to improve the quality of the product and services. And this may make a system, this may become a process, etc. So similarly, if you have to define the product term quality, you have to define it by the needs of the customer. Now, what is customer? Anyone who is impacted by the product or process delivered by an organization. So there may be different kinds of customer. One may be external customer, that is the end user, as well as the intermediate processors. Other external customer may not be purchasers, but may have a connection with the product. internal customer, that means if a company is manufacturing the product, other divisions of the company that may receive the processed product. So what is the product? That is the output of the process carried out by the organization. So it may be goods, for example, automobile, missile, software. So for example, a computer code, a report, a service that is you are receiving from banking and insurance company, all these. So customer is impacted by the product or service, whichever is produced by the organization. And the product is the output of the various processes which are performed by the organization. So it may be goods, it may be software, it may be service. Now question arises, how is customer achieved? How customer satisfaction is achieved? There are two dimensions. First is product dimension and second is freedom from deficiencies. Here, when we talk about the product dimensions, we are concerned with the product feature. For example, it refers to quality of a design. For example, examples in manufacturing industry, its performance, how it perform for the purpose for which it is meant. It's a reliability that it will continue to provide service in the future. It's a durability that it will not be going to waste very easily. And its easiness to use and its aesthetic sense, all are the examples of the product features. Similarly, in the service industry, the accuracy of the service, timeliness of the service, friendliness and courtesy, knowledge of the server, etc., are the examples of the service industry if we consider the service features are concerned. Secondly, the product is referred to as a quality product when it is free from any kind of deficiencies. So it refers to, when we talk about free from the deficiencies, it refers to quality of conformance. So higher conformance means fewer complaints and increased customer satisfaction. So that is, it is related from free from defects. So nothing kind of defect is there in product or service, and you are providing with full zeal and commitment to the customers and satisfying their needs. Now from this there are number of why quality is needed in product and services. Why not we focus only on the product features and left it to the customer whether they buy it or not? There are number of reasons for quality becoming a cardinal priority for most of the organization. One is, there is a lot of competition in the market. So today's market demand high quality products at low cost. If you will not provide the quality products, your competitors will provide and the customers will switch over to that competitor. So having high quality reputation is not enough. So even we have to focus on the cost. So internal cost of maintaining the reputation should be less. So secondly, the customers are changing very rapidly. The new customer is not only commanding priority based on volume, but it is more demanding about the quality system. So the customer tastes and preferences are changing. Customers switch over to the other products and services. Customer may deny to accept the services. There are a number of reasons. That's why we must focus on the quality. Similarly, there is a changing product mix, that is shift from low volume, high price to high volume, low price, having resulted in a need to reduce the internal cost of poor quality. So we must provide the mixture of the products and services so that customers is getting high volume with low price. So that's why we can satisfy the customer needs. Similarly, there is a complexity in the product. As the system have become more complex, the reliability requirement for the suppliers of the components have become more stringent. So that's why there are number of competitors in the market. They are offering different kinds of the products with the different dimensions, features, and sometimes customers become confused. So with this scenario in view, you have to focus on your quality, and higher level of customer satisfaction is needed. Higher customer expectations are getting spawned by increasing competition. So relatively simpler approaches to quality, that is product inspection for quality control, incorporation of internal cost of poor quality into the selling price, might not work today's complex market environment. So market environment is very, very complex. So there are a number of issues regarding the complexity of the products, changing demands of the customers, and increasing competition, and similarly product mix which is a changing scenario in everyday situation, that is the reason that we must focus on the quality. Now, what are the perspectives of the quality? How we define the quality in one particular perspective, and accordingly you have to focus on the quality issues. So most important aspect is number one, everyone define quality based on their own perspective. So it is not there that everyone has the same perspective regarding the product quality and product services. So therefore, we have to typically respond about the definition of quality, which will include number one, perfection. First of all, your product must be perfect. Perfect here means perfectly meeting the requirements of the customer in terms of fitness for use. Secondly, it should provide the service of the product consistently. There should not be any break of providing the service. And you have to eliminate the waste when you have to provide the product quality and service to the customer. Similarly, there should be a speed of delivery. Sometimes we purchase the product, and if there is any defect and which require immediate attention of the supplier to get it repaired, if you don't respond speedily, then your customer will be annoyed and they will switch over to the other manufacturer's products and services. Similarly, you have to comply with the policies and the procedures. Whatever you have promised while selling the product or service to the customer, you must comply with that. If you must not change the policies immediately. Similarly, doing it right the first time. Doing it right, that means nothing should be wrong with your products and services, and you must provide these products and services with full accuracy. You must delight or please the customer. So sometimes a customer has very, very impatient because they have put their money into the product and service. And if you will not provide them the good service, or your product is not qualitative, or you are handling the situation to please the customer is not comfortable, and your behavior with the customer is not favorable or pleasing behavior, then they will be absolutely very, very difficult situation, and they will annoy and switch over to the other production services which are produced by the other manufacturer. So these are the quality perspectives. So here, when we talk about quality perspective, so it means total customer satisfaction and service. So when a customer is absolutely satisfied, your product and service is meeting their all customer needs and perceptions, so it means your product is qualitative product. So here, the quality perspective include perfection, it include consistency, it include elimination of the waste, speed of delivery, compliance with the policies and procedure, doing it right the first time, and delighting or pleasing the customer, and total customer satisfaction or service. Now, there are number of levels at which you can improve the quality. First, at organization level, and second, at the process level where the products and services are produced. Now, let's discuss first at the organization level. We need to ask the following questions if you want to focus quality at the organization level. Number one, which products and services meet your expectations? So meeting your expectation means which product or service is going to benefit the organization by providing the return, absolutely expected rate of return. Secondly, which product and services you need that you are not currently receiving? So you will focus whether the presently the products and services which are produced by you are meeting your expectation. This question you must answer. And secondly, if the products and services which are not produced by you, if they have a popularity in the market, and if they have a good response in the market, whether you should manufacture it or outsource it and get it delivered. And secondly, when you have decided about what kind of products and services you have to produce at the organization level, then at the process level, you have to answer the following question. Number one, what products and services are most important to the external customer? Because ultimately, it is the customer who has to use these products and services. If that is not satisfied, so then you will not be able to get the benefit for your organization. Secondly, what processes produce these products and services? Because quality focus will be on the processes of the production services. Similarly, what are the key inputs to these processes? You have to understand that. And which processes have most significant effects on the organizational performance standard. So one is the organization level and second is at the process level. There are certain various views, additional views of quality in services, because technical quality versus functional quality, these are the new issues which has come into recently in picture. First is technical quality, the core element of the goods and services. That should be very perfect. Secondly, the functional element, that is the functional quality, the customer perception of how the goods and goods functions and the service is delivered, that needs to be focused. Similarly, expectations and perceptions of the customers are very, very important. Customers' prior expectation, generalized and specified service experience, and their perception of service performance affect their satisfaction with service. So satisfaction will equal to perception of the performance, perception what they feel minus expectation. So if your perception is lesser and expectation meet, so both should be a balance. Only then you will receive a satisfaction. There are a number of historical philosophies of the quality which is propounded by the various authors. We will be discussing some of them now. First, there are a number of quality gurus who has done a lot of work in the field of total quality management, and they have been identified for making significant contribution to improve the quality of goods and services. And a few of the very, very important names are Walter A. Schwartz, W.E. Deming, Joseph M. Juran, Ermond Fengbaum, Philip Crosby, Genichi Taguchi, and Kaoru Ishikawa. So these are the persons, most of them belongs to Japan. So therefore, they have done very good work in the field of quality management, and they have defined the quality management from their experience, from the perspective of the customers, and they have also defined the various levels how the quality is improved. Let's discuss some of them. So we'll be discussing three very important authors, Crosby, Deming, and Juran, who has given the various parameters of quality to all of us. First, the definition of quality. If we look at the definition of the Crosby, he said that quality is that aspect which conforms to the specification. So whatever is demanded by the customer in terms of specification, if you are in a position to satisfy them, conform to such specification, that means you are providing a quality product. Secondly, Deming said that a predictable degree of uniformity and dependability at low cost and suited to the market. If some kind of uniformity and dependability is demanded by the market and you are providing that suitability and uniformity at a cost which suits to the customer, then it means you are providing the quality product. Similarly, Juran said that when a product is fit for use means the purpose for which the customer is asking for this product and service. If that is fit for use, it means that is a qualitative product. Secondly, both of these authors has defined the degree of senior management responsibility to improve the quality. As far as Crosby is concerned, Crosby said that it is the responsibility of the senior management for improving the quality. But Deming says that 85% quality problems for that is responsible for the senior management. Others are responsible by the junior management. But Juran said, less than 20% of the quality problems are due to the workers. It means 80% problems are due to the management, because they may be lacking in taking good decisions. They may be not speedy in taking decisions. They may be not very conscious about the quality improvement. So that is the reason. This is the result according to their research which they have done. And thirdly, regarding the performance standard and motivation, Crossbuy says if there is a zero defects, only then quality products is there. But Deming says quality has many scales, use statistics to measure performance in all areas. So critical of zero defects. So there may not be zero defects in any situation, and that situation cannot be achieved easily. So there are scales. He says up to a scale, you have to see whether products according to conformity is produced or not. Juran says that avoid campaigns to do the perfect work. So campaign should not be there. We must focus on the quality. And regarding the general approach, regarding the improvement of quality, Crossbuy says prevention is required, not inspection. So it is not there once you have produced the products, then you are moving toward the inspection. So you must, prevention is better than cure. Deming says reduce variability by continuous improvement and cease mass inspection. Mass inspection should not be there, and we should try to focus on continuous improvement. Similarly, Juran says that general management approach to quality is needed, and especially human elements must be taken into account. Similarly, regarding the structure, we will discuss in detail later on that as far as Crossbuy is concerned, he has given 14 steps for quality improvement. Deming has also given 14 points for management to quality improvement, and Juran has given 10 steps to quality improvement. So according to their experience, according to their research, they have given various concepts of the quality and various steps to improve the quality. So this I have taken from the John S. Auckland Total Quality Management book, which was published in 1989, and on the pages of 291 to 292, this comparison is given. So similarly, regarding the statistical processes, quality control, Crossbuy rejects statistical acceptable levels of the quality. He said no need of, we must be focusing on 100% quality. Deming says statistical method of quality control must be used. Juran says he has recommended statistical quality control, but warned that it can lead to tool-driven approach. That should not be there. Human approach should be focused. For the basis of improvement basis, Crossbuy says ki a process, not a program, improve goals. Deming says continues to reduce variation and eliminate goals without methods. Juran, he said the project by project team approach should be followed and set goals should be set. Regarding the teamwork, Crossbuy says quality improvements team must be there, and quality council should be established in every organization to improve the quality. Deming says ki employees' participation in decision making must be there. Breaking down barriers between various departments must be there so that they can discuss with each other for the improvement of the quality. Juran also focus on team and quality circle approach, because Juran belongs to Japan and quality circle concept was developed there. Cost of the quality. Now, cost of non-performance should not be there, and it should be quality is must be free for that. Deming says no optimum and continuous improvement in cost is required, and quality is not free. Juran said ki there is an optimum cost should be there. So we must follow the statistical quality control and use the techniques of linear programming and other techniques of the operation research to arrive at a conclusion so that the full utilization of the resources may be ensured. Similarly, regarding purchasing and goods which is received, so they Crossbuy says state requirement must be stated, supplier is extension of the business, most faults due to purchase themselves are there. So you must have the absolutely professional approach regarding the purchase and selecting the goods, etc. Deming says inspection is too late, allows defects to enter into the system. So artificial quality intelligence, statistical evidence and control charts are required. He has prescribed all these things in his theory also. Juran says the problems are complex. We must carry on the formal surveys to improve that. Regarding vendor rating, they says buyer's quality audit must be useless. There must be vendor rating. So Deming says no, vendor rating should not be there, critical of the MOST system. And Juran also accepted that vendor rating should be there, but help supplier to improve. Similarly, single sources of supply, Crossbuy has not said anything about it. Deming says yes, single sources must be developed because you have to improve their product continuously with the help of the your employer. You must go for that. Similarly, no, Juran says no, we can neglect to sharpen competitive edge. So these are the different views regarding the quality of the products. So similarly, there are certain quality gurus. Walter A. Schwartz has given certain contribution to the quality. He said because he was a statistician at Bell Laboratories, he has developed statistical control process method to distinguish between random and non-random variation in the industrial processes to keep processes under control. Similarly, the Schwartz has developed a plan, do, check, act, PDCA, which we will be discussing later on, cycle that emphasizes the need for continuous improvement in the quality. So here's work of the Walter and Schwartz has strongly influenced the Deming and Juran, which they later on propounded various theories for the quality improvement. So as far as Schwartz plan is concerned regarding the plan, do, check, act cycle, he has given one cycle. He said, first we must plan, then we must perform, that is action, that is do. Once you have done it, during that you must check it, and if some deficiencies are there, then you must act it. So Schwartz has given one plan, do, check, act cycle, which is very, very important, and many organizations are following it. So this is a Schwartz contribution to the quality improvement and total quality management. The PDCA cycle is given by Schwartz. Similarly, W. Edward Deming, he advocated the statistical process control. He has given various methods which signal shift in the process that would likely to lead to products or services not meeting customer requirement. He emphasized on organizational approach to managing quality and demonstrated that quality products are less costly than the poor quality products. And he has identified 14 critical points for improving the product quality. Similarly, he has introduced Deming Prize, highest award for industrial excellence in the Japan. He was the propounder of this prize, and this has led to give motivation to the various manufacturers to produce quality products and services. Deming has given a 14-point program for improving quality. These include, first, he has created consistency of purpose for the improvement of the product services. There must be, in your effort, consistency should be there. You must adopt a new philosophy of the quality products, and we must cease dependence upon the mass inspection and the practice of awarding business on the price tag alone. We must improve constantly and forever the system of production and training. We must institute training concept and training culture in your organization. We must drive out of fear. We must break barriers between staff areas. There should not be a barrier that this is senior, this is junior. They must discuss by sitting in the quality circle. Eliminate slogan, exhaustion, and targets for the work performance, workforce. Eliminate numeral quotas. Remove barriers to pride in workmanship. Institute a vigorous program of education and retraining, and you must take action to accomplish the program. So we will end this here because there are a number of other contributions are there. We will be discussing it in the next lecture. So today we have tried to discuss on the various concepts of the quality management and the philosophies of the quality, which has been propounded by the various experts through their experience while working in the various industrial organizations. So basically, quality is a concept of mind. Quality is a perception of mind of the customer, what they drive, what they demand. It is a fitness of use. It is an essential characteristics. It distinguishes the product from other products. Similarly, it is a customer satisfaction and fitness for you. So similarly, various authors have given various benefits and definitions of the quality. So we will be moving towards the next author after that. So thank you very much. Now you can on your video, and if you have any query, you can ask. Yes, Aditya.
No queries, sir.
Okay. Akshit.
Sir, no query.
Nishtha.
No, sir.
Shaina. I'm just checking whether you are there or not. Shaina.
No, sir.
Naina. Okay, if you don't have any query, you can leave the class because other class has to join on the same platform. Okay, thank you.